I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Welcome to worship. I'm so glad that you're here today. I want to teach you a second installment of A Plus Faith. Today, we're going to talk about A Plus Kingdom Faith, and you are going to be blessed by the Word of God and the application of God that you can receive now to make a difference in your faith. Stay with me and you'll see that this is a timely word from the Lord. Let's pray. Father, we thank you this morning. We are so blessed and honored to be here. We are so grateful that you are God, and besides you, there is none other. You are omnipotent. You're omnipresent, you're omniscient, you're Jehovah, our provider and our supplier. We thank you that you are the head, hallelujah. And God, we give you the glory that's due your name, for you're the great I am. We lift you high, we magnify, and we adore you. Glory be to God. We just submit to your will this morning that you, Father, would be the teacher. Thank you for the teaching ministry of the Holy Spirit. God, let the word flow unhindered, unchecked, and let it be received, glory to God, for immediate, glory to God, deposit of results. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, and amen. God bless you again this morning. We are just blessed to be here. We send our love to you, glory to God, and we are thankful for your prayers and your support. If you will, amen. Glory to God. Want to be a blessing to this ministry. You can do that by giving to $Ignite1. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Ignite1. $Ignite1. IOWC. IOWC. So find us, be a blessing, and you'll see the information on your screen later. But let's get into this second portion of this word of God this morning. We talked about in our first installment, we dealt with how that the scripture comes out of Corinthians 13, and it tells us that we should test and evaluate, amen, our faith to see whether or not we are in the faith. And we went to Genesis 22, and I gave you eight factors of an A-plus faith. Glory to God, meaning that when we say A plus faith, we're talking about a faith that is superior, or faith that operates at its highest level, or it's the highest level to be attained. It really means the best standard, the best service, the best satisfaction, that is counted of high value and worth. I want to say that there's nothing more important than the worth of your faith as a believer. It is also to be recognized for maximum and exceptional and excellent level in operation. That is the meaning of what an A plus is all about. And so we said that A plus has a pattern and a process that's relatable to your history, but is really revelational to your destiny. Glory to God. And I gave you those eight factors. Accountability, where God went to Abraham and said, he tested him, and Abraham said, here I am, I'm available, I'm usable, I'm reliable, I'm pliable, and I want to be profitable. Amen. And when God begins to confirm your faith, he will give you directions with no detail, and the details will come when he can trust your heart and he can confirm his faith in you, not just your faith in him. Glory to God. Amen. Accountability, assignment, action, affirmation, assurance, alignment, agreement. Glory to God. Agreement is a now faith moment in the process of your revelation of faith. Amen. And then acknowledgement. Those are the eight factors of an A plus faith. And today I want to teach you the second installment of this series, A plus faith. Glory to God. If you will, let's read Matthew 6:33. You know this, you scholars. Seek ye first the kingdom of God, hallelujah, and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Wow. Amen. I love the amplified version of that. It says, aim at and strive after first his kingdom and his righteousness. The CEV version says, put God work first and do what he wants. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. So we're talking about a plus faith, and an A plus faith is a kingdom faith. Yeah, an A plus faith is a kingdom faith. Glory be to God. I'm going to say it again. An A plus faith is a kingdom faith. So the question becomes then, we really need to know what's a kingdom faith if an A plus faith is a kingdom faith. Here is, amen, my definition of kingdom faith. So when I say kingdom faith, at this, A plus is this. Kingdom faith is a functioning system of order and authority in which God reigns in sovereign dominion and influence in spiritual territory. Ooh, that's good. Glory to God. That's kingdom faith. Kingdom faith is a functioning system. So please get this. Faith in the kingdom is a system. Yeah, glory to God. It's a system that moves, glory to God, and operates on certain kingdom levels. Hallelujah. It's a functioning system of order and authority in which God reigns and in sovereign dominion and influence in spiritual territory. Glory to God. Watch it. In heaven and in earth. Glory be to God. That's kingdom faith. That's kingdom faith. I want to be practical today in this teaching. I want to get it to you so that you can receive and apply what I'm teaching. I'm not going to teach over your head. Amen. I'm going to, amen, simplify, amen, clarify, and magnify the word of God so that you can receive this morning. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Wow. Okay. You got kingdom faith. So here it is. The next question would be, why is kingdom faith important to us as believers? Yeah. Amen. Hallelujah. We can talk about Abraham's faith. We can talk about Moses' faith. We can talk about, amen, Joshua's faith. Glory to God. But the reality is, what about my faith? What about your faith? What about, amen, where we are and what we need, glory to God, to overcome, and what we need, amen, to get out of struggles, and what we need to believe to the next level? I want to help you this morning. You need to go ahead, amen, and share this and tell somebody, amen, that if you need a faith boost, glory to God, this morning, the word of God is here and you can join in. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Oh my, hallelujah. Why is kingdom faith important? Why is A plus kingdom faith important to us as believers? Number one, family, is that we cannot, amen, function in the will of God without having faith. Ooh, that was deep. Glory to God. We cannot function in the will of God without having faith. Faith is a kingdom commodity, amen, that when it becomes consistent, glory to God, it will manifest results in the spirit. Yeah, hallelujah, glory to God. So number one, we cannot function in the will of God without having faith, glory to God. Then number two, watch this please, if faith is not action, it becomes inactive. If faith is not action, it becomes inactive. Why? Because faith is alive. Faith is alive. Glory to God. That's why Hebrews said, now faith is. Glory to God. Faith is alive. If it's not action, it becomes inactive. Hallelujah. Wow. Amen. Listen to this. Listen to this. Listen to this. James chapter number 2, verse number 17, we're talking about A plus kingdom faith. James chapter number 2, verse number 17. I love the Amplified Version. Here it is. Watch this. It says, faith, if it does not have deeds and actions of obedience to back it up, woo, by itself, it's destitute of power. Good God Almighty. It is inoperative and it's dead. Oh my God. James chapter 2, verse number 17, the Amplified Bible. Faith, if it does not have deeds and actions of obedience to back it up, by itself, it is inoperative and is dead. That is the scripture, the word of God. I believe, amen, the King James simply says that faith without works is dead. Glory to God. Now you got it. Hallelujah. Wow. Amen. Listen, please, because we got to understand that this A plus kingdom faith, man, is a functioning system, amen, that we as believers should begin, should know how to operate in, amen, as we learn to walk with God. Hallelujah. Colossians chapter number 2, verse 6 and 7. Here it is. As ye therefore have received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk ye in him. How did you receive him? You received him by faith. Yeah, amen. Watch it, please. Numbers, verse 7. Rooted and built up in him and established where? In the faith, as you have been taught, abounding therein with thanksgiving. Woo, hallelujah. Let me give you, amen, the NLT version of this here. Watch it, please. Let your roots grow down into him and let your life be built on him. Oh, wow. So what we can already see, amen, that when we talk about A plus kingdom faith, we're really talking about, amen, faith has to have a foundation level. Yeah, amen, amen. Let your roots grow down in him. Let your life be built on him. Then your faith will grow strong in the truth you were taught. Hallelujah. And you will overflow with thankfulness. That's a good word for somebody right there. Let your roots grow down into him and let your life be built on him. Hallelujah. Ah, oh, my God. Woo, Shammai Shai. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father, for the word this morning. Stay with me, family. We are about to turn the corner. Hallelujah. I feel the Holy Ghost. We're about to turn the corner. Amen. Glory to God. As we're talking about this A plus kingdom faith. A plus kingdom faith. A plus kingdom faith. Glory to God. Wow. Amen. We'll find it in Mark's Gospel, chapter 11, Jesus talking to his disciples and teaching them lessons of life and faith along the way as they follow him. He says to them, have faith in God. Mark 11, 22, have faith in God. And it really results to this, that when Jesus said to have faith in God, he was teaching them that, watch this, that a part of your lifestyle as believers and disciples, glory to God, is that you have to have faith to say. Yeah, you got to have faith to believe, and you have to have faith to see, and you have to have faith to receive. Did you get that? Glory to God. Faith to say, faith to believe, faith to see, and even faith to receive. Mark 11, I'm telling you, 22, have faith in God. Verse 23, for verily I say to you that whosoever shall say, there it is, faith to say unto this mountain, be removed and cast into the sea, you shall, and watch this, and not doubt in his heart, but shall believe. There it is. Faith to believe. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe. Those things which he saith shall come to pass. Yeah. And he shall have. Yeah. Glory to God. He shall have. Glory to God. Those things shall come to pass, faith to see, and he shall have whatsoever he said. Glory to God. Faith to receive. Amen. Therefore, I say to you, whatever you believe, when you pray, Glory to God. Believe that you receive them and you shall have them. My, hallelujah. Amen. Kingdom faith, A plus kingdom faith, is faith to say, faith to believe, faith to see, and faith to receive. Glory to God. Did you get that? Watch it, please. Because if kingdom faith, hallelujah, is a functioning system based on what we just read, don't miss this, please, based on what we just read here in Mark's Gospel, chapter number 22, watch it, please, then what you need to pick up, glory to God, this morning is that if kingdom faith is a faith system, a functioning system, and then, glory to God, watch this, it is based on faith to say, glory to God, then watch it, please. Ooh, my hallelujah. Get ready. Hallelujah. Watch it. Your mouth is a functioning system. Glory to God. Your mouth is a functioning system of access and active influence and authority of God's kingdom power. Your mouth is, glory to God, hallelujah, a functioning system. If that's true and the revelation, glory to God, is true, glory to God, hallelujah, watch it in the scripture, in the text. Not only your mouth is a functioning system, hallelujah, ooh, my shakaba, your heart is a functioning system. Your heart is a functioning system when it comes to A plus kingdom faith, hallelujah. Watch it. He said, glory to God, do not doubt in his heart. Those that don't doubt in their heart. Don't doubt in their heart. Why? See, doubt is not the absence of faith, family. No, it's not the absence of faith. Doubt is the questioning of faith. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We won't go there. We don't have time to do it. Amen. That's exactly how, amen, the serpent deceived in the beginning. Glory to God. It was not that they hadn't been taught the faith. They had been taught the principle. They had been taught what to do. It was the enemy coming in to cause their faith to be questioned. Glory to God. Glory to God. And hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. And we know the Bible say, amen, that if any man doubt, let him not think he will receive anything, glory to God, of the Lord. Hallelujah. Watch it, see, your mouth is a functioning system, glory to God. Your heart is a functioning system in kingdom, amen, glory to God, A plus faith. Then your mind is a functioning system in kingdom, A plus faith, glory to God. Your mind, glory to God, your mind is. Then watch it, please. Therefore, I say whatsoever you desire. Ooh, your desire is a functioning system in the glory to God of A plus kingdom faith. Because it, my shot, glory to God, it brings faith alive. It makes faith accountable. It makes faith rewardable. Glory to God when we release it to God. Hallelujah. Please get this. Watch it, please. It says, amen. When you pray, whatsoever thing you desire, your desire is a functioning system. When you pray, believe, hallelujah. Then here it is, your prayer life is a functioning system of kingdom, A plus faith, glory to God. Somebody ought to get that right there, hallelujah, glory to God, amen. Your mind, your mouth, your heart, your desires, your mind and your prayer life all are a part of a functioning system of kingdom, A plus faith. And when we really look at that, we're talking about, amen, glory to God, a functioning system of order and authority where God reigns in sovereign dominion, glory to God, and influence in spiritual territory. That's why the devil want to fight you. That's why he want to keep your mouth closed. He want to keep your heart heavy. He want to keep your mind worried, glory to God. He want to keep your prayer life, amen, on the shallow end, because he understands, glory to God, that there's a functioning system of authority, hallelujah, amen, in order in A plus kingdom faith that will give you, glory to God, a victory over, hallelujah, every enemy. Somebody give God a praise for the victory, hallelujah, this morning. Come on, church, hallelujah, glory to God. If you can see it like that, if the ecclesia can really understand that faith is a functioning system and your mouth is a functioning system, you wouldn't be, hallelujah, quiet when you go through. You'll learn how to open your mouth and give God praise. If you can understand your mind is a functioning system, you would, glory to God, think on, hallelujah, these things. Glory to God. When I think of the goodness, glory to God, of Jesus and all that, amen. Your desires is a functioning system. Glory to God. He'll give you the desires of your heart. Your prayer life is a functioning system. Men should always pray. Glory to God. So you got to get it. If we can just get that as the body, glory to God, as individuals, if we can get this revelation of A plus kingdom faith and begin to develop and operate in the principle of that kind of faith, man, we would be unstoppable. Glory to God. We would always be steadfast and unmovable and always abounding in the will of God. Glory to God. We wouldn't have a problem receiving by faith, and we wouldn't have a problem when it's time to release our faith. Glory to God. Why? Because we understand that there's a functioning system attached. And glory to God, there's a kingdom order and authority. Glory to God, there's a kingdom influence. Glory to God, connected to my A plus kingdom faith. Glory to God, hallelujah. Here it is, see, watch it please. When we really get the revelation of an A plus kingdom faith and understand it's a functioning system, there's a discovery to be made. The discovery is, watch this, the discovery is this, that we will understand, glory to God, that kingdom, that the kingdom is connected to the power of what we release, not just what we receive. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. That's my shoko. Hallelujah. I need to speak to somebody right through here, because you think that your faith only works when it's time for you to receive. Glory to God. But I'll come to tell you this morning, glory to God, that your faith is more powerful when it's released. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Matter of fact, lift your hands right where you are. Father, in Jesus' name, hallelujah. I touch and agree with each and every person under the sound of my voice right now, God, that they would, glory to God, that through this revelation, we release our faith for what we're believing for in expectation. Glory to God, hallelujah. And by the time we finish this lesson, we'll have, glory to God, the tools, glory to God, to bring it into our manifestation, hallelujah, in the mighty name of Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Yeah, amen. It's more powerful, glory to God, when we learn how to release it than it is, glory to God, when we're receiving anything by faith. Hallelujah. Yeah, amen. We know that the scripture tells us, Proverbs 23:18, glory to God, that life and death of where? In the power of the tongue. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So listen, your next miracle could be in your mouth. Your next manifestation could be in your mouth. Your next victory, amen, may have not surfaced because you've been keeping your mouth closed about something that's trying to get the victory over you. Glory to God. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Glory to God. A plus kingdom faith is active. It's an active faith, family. It's an active faith. I want to give you this. I want to give you three things you can do to activate your faith right now, at this moment, starting today. Glory to God, according to the word of God. I want to give you three things you can begin to develop in your faith life, in your faith walk, that will activate your faith. Glory to God, and then it will increase your faith and get you on the journey toward an A-plus kingdom faith. I pray that you are, hallelujah, that you're ready for this. Glory to God, hallelujah. Here it is, watch it. Number one is you got to speak your faith. Yeah, you got to speak your faith. Speak your faith. That's number one. Speak your faith. 2 Corinthians 4:13, Paul says, I speak, therefore I believe. Come on, somebody. Glory to God. You got to speak your faith. Speak your faith. It got to come out of your mouth. even though it may begin in your heart and may even be in your head. You got to bring your mouth to the party. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Speak your faith. Glory to God. Speak your faith. Glory to God. Number two, watch it. Number two, the second thing you need to do to activate your faith to be start to become an A-plus kingdom faith, glory to God, is share your faith. Share your faith. Psalm 34, oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Share your faith. Glory to God. Yeah, share your faith. Be a witness. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Of the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Share your faith. Share your faith. Number one, speak your faith. Number two, share your faith. Here it is. Number three, show your faith. Good God Almighty. That's a good word right there. Glory to God. Share your faith. Speak your faith. Show your faith. But I got Bible for you. Mark Gospel chapter number 5, beginning around verse 25 through 34. We know, amen, that before this, Jesus is on his way, amen, to heal this man's daughter named Jairus, glory to God. And as he's on his way, he pulls up in the neighborhood, and there's this woman there, glory to God, that had this issue for 12 years, glory to God, and she hears that Jesus is coming, glory to God, and she steps into this third dimension of how to increase and activate an A-plus kingdom faith. Glory to God. She gives us some principles and some parameters in how to show our faith. Glory to God. How did she show her faith? Glory to God. I'm telling you, here it is. Glory to God. Watch this. In order to show your faith, this woman teaches us that you must be willing to press. Glory to God. You must be willing to press, meaning she leaned into her expectation. Good God Almighty. Glory to God. She leaned into her expectation by the faith that she had in spite of the disappointment that had already came. Woo! My God, hallelujah. Let me rewind that and give it to you another way. She leaned into her expectation by the desire she had in spite of the disappointment that had already came. Good God Almighty. Glory to God. Hallelujah. She didn't stop believing. Glory to God. She watched it. She pressed her way through to her breakthrough. Ooh, glory to God. The Bible says, glory to God. Hallelujah. She released a touch. Hallelujah, in faith, and she received the touch of faith back. Oh, my God, hallelujah. There is no way, glory to God, hallelujah, glory to God. There's no way, glory to God, I'm going to ask you if you touch me if I didn't feel you touch me. Glory to God. Because if you didn't touch me, and I keep saying you who touched me or you touched me, then I got the question, what's going on with me? Glory to God. But no. Glory to God. Glory to God. She touched, hallelujah, his clothes, and he felt it. Jesus felt it. Why? Because she was willing to press in and lean into her expectation. Glory to God. With her desire, in spite of her past disappointment. I speak over you this morning that somebody, amen, that disappointment, glory to God, has caused your faith to be limited. Disappointment has caused your faith to almost be dead. Disappointment has caused your faith, amen, glory to God, to be detoured. But today, glory to God, hallelujah, step up, hallelujah, show your faith, share your faith, amen, speak your faith. It is still alive, glory to God, and you can, hallelujah, receive, glory to God, in spite of your last disappointment. Hallelujah. Here it is. Watch this now. Here's the revelation the Lord gave me when I was reading this. Glory to God. Hallelujah. My God. She touched him, and then she got a touch back. Glory to God. So watch it, please. When we look at the story, beginning at verse number 25, glory to God, before she tapped into an A-plus kingdom faith by showing her faith, before that, here it is, she was just a woman with an issue. Hallelujah. Selah. She was just a woman with an issue. Hallelujah. I don't know what woman may be listening and what woman may, amen, come across this, and you may have been characterized, amen, and categorized as a woman with an issue. But today, glory to God, it can change. It will change if you would just release your faith and trust God. Hallelujah. And don't doubt. Hallelujah. Here it is. She was just a woman with an issue until her actions became an example of A-plus kingdom faith. Wow, glory to God. Her actions became an example of A-plus kingdom faith, amen, to the disciples and to the whole crowd that was around. When Jesus pulled up, glory to God, she leaned into her expectation. Hallelujah, glory to God. And she got her need met. Hallelujah, watch this. She went from being just a woman with an issue to a daughter. Did you hear what I said? Glory to God. The Bible said that she pressed through, broke through, touched his clothes, and Jesus said, I felt a touch. Glory, who touched me? Hallelujah. Glory to God. I felt it leave me. I felt it leave me. And the scripture says immediately, hallelujah, she felt it in her body. Glory to God. And her issue dried up. Are you hearing what I'm saying? She went from a woman with an issue to a daughter. Hallelujah. Watch it. Jesus converses with this woman after she comes and say, I'm responsible. I'm accountable. It was me. I touch you. Jesus says, daughter, your faith, good God Almighty, has made you whole. In other words, watch this. She went from just a woman with an issue to being called a daughter of faith. Good God Almighty, a daughter of faith. Why? Because she showed it in her A-plus kingdom faith. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hey, my shot. Hallelujah. You don't have to stay a woman with an issue. Glory to God. Glory to God. You can touch him and he'll touch you back. You love him, he'll love you back. Yay, my, you be faithful to him, he'll be faithful to you back. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You don't have to be, glory to God, lonely and alone. No. Glory to God. He said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. Glory to God. I don't care how long you had your issue. Glory to God. If you can exemplify, glory to God, this A-plus kingdom faith and lean into your expectation and give Jesus not a chance, not a try, but just give him your trust. Glory to God. Give him your trust, hallelujah, and you can see, amen, hallelujah, immediately, hallelujah, just like this woman, how she went from a woman with an issue to be called a daughter of faith by Jesus. Whoo, hallelujah. Come on, somebody, receive that. Glory to God. Wow, she became a daughter of faith. She became a daughter of faith. And then, hallelujah, the Holy Ghost exposed to me, hallelujah, amen, how she did it. How she did it. How did she become a daughter of faith from being a woman with an issue in a moment of faith? Wow. In a moment of faith, she went from being a woman with an issue to a daughter of faith. Might I add you, she went from being a woman with an issue for 12 years. May I add, she went to a woman with an issue, glory to God, hallelujah, that seemingly there was no answer to being a daughter of faith. Hallelujah. Just like that. Woo! Glory to God, hallelujah. Glory to God. I speak to you. I speak to you, woman of God, that you're moving into a season, glory to God, where you won't be known as a woman with an issue. Hallelujah. No. God is trying to position you. God wants to position you. Glory to God. And you can position yourself by leaning into your expectation and activating your belief. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So that you can become a daughter of faith. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So here it is. God, it gave me how the Holy Ghost gave me how she did it. How she did it. How did it happen? Glory to God. Watch it. Number one, she imagined it. She imagined it. Glory to God. She imagined. How do I know she imagined it? Because she lived with it for 12 years. She lived with it for 12 years. Glory to God. Nobody wants to have an issue. Amen. Glory to God. So she imagined it. She imagined, glory to God, being free. She imagined being healed. She imagined life being different. Come on. Glory to God. She imagined it. Please get this. Watch this. She imagined it. Glory to God. Because she had it for 12 years. And then the second thing I believe what happened is she envisioned it. How do you know she envisioned it? Because she went to the doctor for it. Glory to God. And the Bible says she went to the doctor after doctor after doctor. And glory to God. And the scripture says, and it did not get better. But yet she envisioned it. Glory to God. She envisioned it. Hallelujah. Here it is. Watch this now. Watch this. And then the Bible said that she heard Jesus pulled up. Glory to God. Watch it. She heard Jesus pulled up. Glory to God. Then watch it. And then what she did was when Jesus pulled up, glory to God, she realized, amen, that there was an opportunity for change in her life. Glory to God. So she invoked it. Yeah, she imagined it, she envisioned it, and she invoked it. She heard Jesus coming. Amen. Glory to God. Watch it now. And then when she heard Jesus was coming, and when he got there around the crowd, amen, watch this, please. Not only did she imagine it and envision it and invoked it, she voiced it. She voiced it. She said, if I could just touch his clothes, I know I'll be made. She voiced it. She voiced it. She voiced it. Glory to God. She voiced it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. She voiced it, and then she pressed through the crowd to get to her breakthrough. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I want to encourage you. Amen. The next time. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Here it is. Your next miracle is voice activated. Your next blessing is voice activated. Glory to God. Don't just put your mouth on it. Now you got to put some action to it. Glory to God. She voiced it and she stretched through, glory to God, the crowd to touch him where she leaned into. Wow. She touched him where she leaned into, touched his clothes. She felt it. Wow. And then finally, she received it. Wow. She received it. Verse 29 say immediately the bleeding stopped and she felt in her body that she was healed. She received it. Did you get it? She imagined it. She envisioned it. She invoked it. She voiced it and she received it. Glory to God. Wow. That's how you activate a kingdom A plus faith right there. And glory to God. In other words, here it is. She thought it. She saw it. She saw it. She said it. And then she got it. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Yeah, amen. That's what I'm talking about, this A plus kingdom faith. You got to show it. You got to show it. I don't have time, but there's another example. Amen. I believe it's Luke's gospel chapter number 5. Amen. Where there was a paralyzed man and he had 4 friends. Amen. And they decided, amen. The Bible said Jesus pulled up again. He was in the house and amen. There was a crowd around. Amen. And they went to get this brother healed and they tried to go in the front door. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And they couldn't get in because of the crowd. And the scripture said, and they went on the roof and they began to tear the roof up. They began to break through the roof. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And then they let their friend die. They let him down. Watch this. And the scriptures say, watch it. When Jesus saw their faith. Hallelujah. Yeah, you got to show it. You got to show your faith. When Jesus saw their faith, he began to speak to the man and say, your sins be forgiven. Glory to God. And I won't keep going, but that's just, amen. Amen. Glory to God. So please. This woman went from being a woman with an issue to being a daughter of faith because she thought it, she saw it, she sought it, she said it, and she received it. She received it. Glory to God. She received it. That's a pattern. Glory to God. Yeah, that's a pattern and a principle right there. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Wow. Glory to God. I'm closing. I pray you're being blessed by this word, but I'm closing. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Sarah, glory to God. She exposes us to another version of A-plus kingdom faith. The scripture says, Hebrews 11, glory to God, 11 through 13. It was by faith that even Sarah, watch this, was able to have a child, though she was barren and was too old. I need you to get it, because she's got two things working against her, amen, that makes it impossible. She's barren and she's old, beyond the age. Glory to God. Here it is. She's barren and she's old, but watch it. She believed that God would keep his promise. That's all the difference right there. Woo, my God. She believed that God would keep his promise. She believed that God would keep his promise. Watch verse 12. And so a whole nation came from this one man who was as good as dead. A nation with so many people that, like the stars in the sky and in the sand of the seashore, there's no way to count them. Wow. Glory to God. Wow. She believed that God would keep his promise. Glory to God. And then her belief connected to her husband's belief. Glory to God. 13. And these people, watch it now. And these people died still believing what God had promised. They did not receive what was promised, but they saw it all from a distance and welcomed it. They agreed that they were foreigners and nomads here on earth. Wow. 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 There's so much in there to unpack. Glory to God. Hallelujah. This A-plus kingdom faith, it's active, it's alive, it's operative. Watch this. It's operative even against barriers and even against, amen, what's impossible in your life. If you would just keep believing whatever God promised. Wow. 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 So there's some things that got to happen with this A-plus kingdom faith, according to Sarah's example of what it is. What has to happen, glory to God, to faith? Number one, you got to be persuaded by it. They all died still believing what God promised. You got to be persuaded that the promise of God has so much authority, so much affluence, so much, amen, hallelujah, order, and it's a functioning system that's connected to your faith, glory to God, that you got to believe beyond the impossible. They were persuaded by it. Then next, here it is, A-plus kingdom faith. You got to see it. The scripture said, watch it, they did not receive it, but they saw it from afar off and they welcomed it. Wow, they saw it from far off. You got to see it. Then the third thing is you got to embrace it. You got to embrace it. They, watch it, they saw it from far off and they welcomed it. You always have to begin to embrace what faith shows you, even though you don't have it yet. Glory to God. Wow. You persuade it by, you see it, you embrace it, and then you confess it. You confess it. Hallelujah. My faith says, I believe when I confess, but better yet, hallelujah, my faith shows I believe when I obey. Good God Almighty. Faith applied is faith undenied. God has to respond to faith. God rewards faith. Faith is a manifestation of what we believe and know about the God that we serve. Glory to God. I close with this scripture. I pray that you've been blessed by the word of God and you got the principle of this A-plus kingdom faith and you got the applicable steps and teaching to activate your faith today as you lean into it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. First Chronicles 29:11-13. Thine, O Lord, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the victory and the majesty. For all that is in the heavens and the earth is thine. Thine is the kingdom, O Lord, and thou art exalted as head above all. Both riches and honor come from you, and you rule over all. In thy hand is power and might, and in thy hand is it to make great and to give strength to all. And now we thank you, our God, and praise your glorious name. Hallelujah. Father, we bless you. Thank you for the word of God this morning. Thank you for teaching us that we can have an A-plus kingdom faith as we learn to share it, we learn to speak it, we learn to show it in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray that the word of God will not return void. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. In Jesus, your son's name. Amen. 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 Hey, be blessed until we see you again next week. I pray that the word has been a blessing to you.